Hi, wrestling fans. Certainly good to be back on this TV again. It's been some times, and it's been nice out playing golf and doing a lot of things that I never got to do as a professional wrestler for 25, 30 years. Real exciting, boy, to get up in the mornings and knowing you don't have to jump on an airplane or jump in a car and go wrestle that night and jump in the car and drive back and drive another 800 miles the next day or get in an airplane with your sore body and your mind really not straightened out yet. It's been real nice, but I talked to my buddy Eddie Marlin. I said, Ed, you know, them days fishing and golfing's about over. I'm watching wrestling on TV and get a little itchy. That's what I done. I got real itchy. I looked up on my TV and you know who I seen? The worst imitation that I have ever seen in my entire life. Let me tell you something, Hart Pally. You don't know what a fabulous Fargo is. You have no earthly idea. You bring two geeks, two guys that you picked up off the street, and you want to make them fabulous dolls from New York. You can forget that, Hart. Let me tell you something, pal. You're a joke and they're a joke. What are you buying? $2 bottle of dye, put it on their hair, and buy them a $25 tuxedo. Let me tell you something, Hart, you punk, and your two little guys from New York. I sweated many a gallon of blood and sweat to be a professional wrestler, and I'm damn proud of it. And there's only one fabulous Fargo from New York, Pally. That was me and Donnie. The pictures you see with the tuxedos, the high hats, the original fabulous Fargos, and a punk like you, Hart, you're going to come along and steal something that I built up all of my life, that I put my pride and my glory in, something that brought me fortune and fame, Hart. Well, you stink, boy. You stink. Now, I'm going to give you some good advice. I promised Eddie Marlin I wouldn't cuss and raise too much cane on his TV, but I can't help it. You stink, Hart. You're too synthetic. New York dolls. What a joke. Let me tell you something, pal. If there's going to be any fabulous ones around, if there's going to be any hi-hats around and tuxedos around, it's going to be first class, and it's going to be who I pick. Not who you pick, Hart. You stink. You stink. You got nothing about you, pal. $25 tuxedo. What a joke. My socks cost more than that, Pally. When I walked around with the top hat on, with the gloves and the sequins, they cost something, boy. They didn't cost 25 cents. You're disgusting. You're disgusting to me. To think what I've put in the wrestling business and you want to come along with this. Well, let me tell you something, Pally. I went out and got me a couple of guys. Tough. That's what you don't have, Hart. You got to be tough. You got to have a heart. You got to have a heart as big as a watermelon, not big as a peanut like you and them two geeks you got. Well, Pally, I got me two wrestlers, and I'm going to put the high hats, and I'm going to put the tuxedos on them. But you know what they can do that your boys can't do? They can fight. They're tough. And if you slap them, you know what they'll do to you? They'll slap the hell out of you. They're going to do that. You're not going to smack them upside the head and walk off and prance around. Time you get your fist back from their jaw, by gosh, you're going to have one upside of your head. That's the only way it's going to be with me, pal. I'm back. The fabulous Jackie Fargo's back. not as a manager, as a consultant. I'm going to advise these two men. And when I say men, I'm talking about men, tough, rugged, fighters that'll kick your teeth in, Hart. You better not show up there. You better not show up in the arena with your boys with no tuxedos on and no hi-hats. You cannot go around imitating me, Pally. I will not give you permission to do that. You have no right, and you have the audacity of you. You little stinky stink. You stink. I got pride. I'm saying this to you right now. I am out of retirement. I want to fight. I want to feel. I want to touch. I want to beat. I want to claw and scratch and dig. That's what I'm known for, and that's what I'll die for. And I'm tough. Don't you forget that, Hart. And don't you boys forget it either. Trying to imitate the Fabulous Fargos, you ain't got a chance. I got two of the greatest men that I've ever seen. They're the ones that's going to wear the tuxedos. They're going to wear the top hats. And yeah, they'll be doing the Fargo strut too, pal. And I'll be proud of them. I'll be proud to say, look at that. Look in the wrestling ring. Look. I look back 25 years ago. I see me and Donnie. They're going to get out there and they're going to give some people some hard times, pal. I'm not going to be running around like you, Hart, with a stick and my manager's hat and all that. I don't need it. But I'm going to be the advisor. I'm going to be the consultant. And I tell anybody, I don't care who it is, you must know this in the wrestling. As a professional wrestler, when you climb in that ring, you don't have friends. I don't care who they get in the ring with, or where, what city. If they ever do not take my advice, then I'll back away from them. But I think I've got the team that wants to be the Fabulous Ones again. And I'm looking forward to it. And I'm telling you again, Hart, don't bring your boys with them little $25 suits on. That's all I got to say, Pally. We'll be right back.
talking about the fabulous ones, the fabulous one himself, Jackie Fargo.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm a very lucky man. I could have looked this world over and never found two finer men and athletes like I found in Steve and Stan, the Fabs, the fabulous ones, and I'm proud to call them that. I devoted my life to being a great wrestler and hard fighter and gentleman. And I know that these men are, they're dedicated their life to wrestling, hard work in the gym, and also to being nice to the fans. That's very important to me. My father told me, son, he said, it's nice to be important, but it's more important to be nice. That's why I'm proud of the Fabs. They're great for it. And now I'd like to show you a piece of film of the Fabs. I think you're really going to enjoy. People over the years ask me, Jackie, does Nuthouse really live in a funny farm in New York, and do you really keep him locked up? And you know, I've just had every question asked about Nuthouse could be asked. Well, I want to tell you one thing. If you have never seen my brother, Nuthouse Roughhouse Fargo, you've really missed something.
The fabulous Fargo's Jackie in the ring right now, and Roughhouse sitting up on the ring. Turnbuckles in there. Here he is. Oh, that Roughhouse. He reared back. He's going to put him in the third row, and then he said, no, we're not going to bother with him. Unbelievable. Rough and tough. Yeah, I saw you, Ruff. Unbelievable.
He is the toughest guy, and I'm going to tell you, he'll smack you in the mouth and smack the referee and smack me if I don't get out of the way.
Ferris comes over to Jackie. They busted Roughhouse open, bleeding by his right eye. And they're pounding at him. Table anyway.
Maybe he is a little funny. I'll look around to tag him, and he might be up in the balcony over in the ladies' restroom. You don't know about the nut, but I'll tell you one thing. When you say, sick him, Nuthouse, he knows what that means. And brother, let me tell you, pal, I'm glad I'm on his side and not on the other side. Because he lives up to his name. He is a nut. Like I said, you never know about the man. And what can I say? He's a nut. Get out of his way when you see him coming.
How are we going to ring the bell when we don't even have a bell? All right, there we are.
Go get him, bell!
10 minutes and 8 seconds, it finally was stopped. Probably about 9 minutes and 8 seconds short. But the action goes on.
We'll be right back.
Fabulous Ones appear at the Mid-South Coliseum, it could be a rock and roll show. Their music plays. Their fans go crazy. It's a rock and roll wrestling show. At the TV5 studios on Saturday, with t-shirts and buttons, their fans will tell you whom they want to see and why.
Because they're good wrestlers and they're good looking. Because he's good looking.
They're crazy. They're good wrestlers. You know? They're cool, too.
And the fans follow them to the Coliseum on Monday night.
Well, they're hot right now. They're cute. They're fun to watch.
These two guys from Florida are incredibly popular. Wrestling fans from across the country have picked them as the most popular tag team around. There's something about the Fabulous Ones that's familiar for old-time wrestling fans. The blonde hair, the style, comes from the Fabulous Fargo brothers, Jackie and John and Roughhouse. Probably the most flamboyant wrestlers in the Mid-South 20 years ago. Jackie Fargo taught the Fabulous Ones about being a tag team, and he gave them their name.
Steve and I have kind of, you know, borrowed from them and kind of turned it into more of an 80s rock type thing. Maybe, you know, we watched the music TV, you know, quite a bit, the videos and stuff, the rock stars, and we just tried to take what they did back in the late 50s and just make it into a current type trend.
First night we wrestled together, as a matter of fact, was here in the Memphis Coliseum, and Jackie had his limousine bring us to the ring. And myself, I had never been in a limousine for the first trip. That was the biggest part of it. To me, it was just getting in the limousine backstage. And then when the lights came on us and the spotlight and the reaction we got from the people, it was just tremendous.
Last night, it was the Fabulous Ones, two-on-two against the Grapplers, fighting for the glory and the fame and the fans. Steve Kern and Stan Lane know what it's like out there in the crowd.
I get the same feeling in turn now when little kids come running up to me, or when you're walking down the street in Memphis and you see somebody kind of like watch you go by, and say, that's why the Fabulous Ones. You hear it, you know, behind your back. They don't want to come up and say anything to you, but at the same time, you know, they know who you are. It's a thrill.
If we didn't show up because we had a headache or a sore throat, or say, you know, we were just in a bad mood and we said, I don't want to do it tonight, that just wouldn't be right, because those people want to see us. So it's just like they'll saying the show must go on. So as long as Steve and I are physically capable of coming, we're going to go out there and give them everything we got.
Everything they've got is what it took. But the Fabulous Ones got the win. much to the delight of their fans.
Everything else. Speaking
a turn. Here he comes. He's got a two before, and he is just pounding the big moon dog. Now all the fabulous ones are in there. Steve Kern, Stan Lane, Jackie Fargo. And the big moon dog is out, and the winners are the fabulous ones.
There they are, climbing into the ring. Steve Kern, Stan Lane, the fabulous ones, and they put it right in the middle of the ring. That trophy signifying that they hold the World Tag Team titles. The trophy on the line here today against the group coming in right now. Jimmy Hart leading his Bruise Brothers team, Pork Chop Cash, the Dream Machine. They're challenging for the World Tag titles today, this championship match. Will be one fall, 60-minute time limit. One fall, 60 minutes, the time limit. Introducing the challengers at a total of 452 pounds from the Windy City, Porkchop Cash, the Dream Machine, the Bruise Brothers. And going against them, the champions at a total of 443 pounds, both from Florida, Steve Kern, Stan.
The Dream Machine starting out for the Bruise Brothers. Stan Lane on the other side of the ring. Bell time, and here we go. With the CWA World Tag title on the line. And the Dream Machine starts out with that werewolf holler of his as Stan Lane ready for him. Tied up, center of the ring, around behind. Nice move from the Dream Machine. Stan kicks out of it. Porkchop Cash over there cheering him on.
Maybe the traveling has got to him, huh?
Excellent move, yeah. What do you think? Jimmy Hart coming over to make a comment about that very effective and legitimate move the Dream Machine made there. Normally, we used to see him clubbing somebody with something in his hand. So. Stan got back and a nice kick out from the Dream Machine.
Right. Don't ever underestimate the Bruise Brothers, baby.
They are looking very sharp, just from the little we've seen the Dream Machine in there. But they're going against two speed merchants and two very strong, well-conditioned ones.
I'm a wimp. Tell them to shut up or I'll leave.
Promises, promises, Jimmy. Crowd getting on Jimmy Hart. As in the ring, Stan Lane, Dream Machine, exchanging some hurts as they are going at it pretty hot and heavy in the very first couple of minutes of action. Steve Kern takes over. Good side mare down to the deck. Steve hanging on to a side headlock on the Dream. The Dream throws him off.
Ooh.
Nice leapfrog. Boy, and the Dream's a big guy, too.
Yes, indeed. Steve went high in the air and cleared him. Came up with the advantage as he put him on the map. On the mat.
Stan and Steve. And typical of their attitude about sharing their success with the fans. It wasn't long after they got that world tag title, and here they are defending it on our championship wrestling on television. And against a very formidable team of the Dream Machine and Porkchop Cash, collectively known as the Bruise Brothers. And a nice throw. Look at Steve. Ooh, beautiful. Really Looked like an arm drag to me, Jim. Dan Lane in, drops with a leg down on the Dream. Chops hadn't been in there yet.
Not at all. It's been Dream Machine for the first 3 minutes, and we are now at the three-minute mark.
Dan Lane hooked the arm up in a hammer position. As Hart's complaining to the referee that Lane was not the legal man. He was, in fact. And into the ropes and a big elbow, and there's a tag on Porkchop Cash. High in the air. The big elbow is for naught. Look at Stan. Steve, a little distracting tactics over there, and now takes the tag and comes in. Side bears Porkchop down. Chop rolled him into a one count, that's all.
Tried it again. That time Steve just kept rolling. Now shoulders down. He was pulling tight, so referee wouldn't start the count.
Calhoun interfered with the Bruise Brother. Now you just saw it. Tell me you didn't.
He broke up an illegal move. He had the tights, Jimmy, in case you couldn't see it from here inside.
That's why.
The referee's on the other side.
That's why you wear glasses and I don't,
oh,
baby.
Okay.
I saw it and you.
When you go sit down. World Tag Title match, and Jimmy Hart's over here complaining about my glasses and whatever. Whoa, what a backdrop. Beauty from Steve Kern, the Bruise Brother. Tag on the Dream.
Yeah, stop. Couldn't get to the corner quick enough for that tag.
He wanted out. In the early stages of a one-fall 60-minute time limit, CWA World Tag Team titles on the line. Fabulous Ones defending against the Bruise Brothers. The referee says legitimate tag, and Porkchop takes over. We're not complaining, Jimmy. The referee signified it was a legitimate tag.
5 minutes gone. 5 minutes have passed. That means 55 minutes left in the time limit.
There's your five-minute mark. As 55 to go, Porkchop Cash now with a handful of hair slams ahead of Steve Kern down on the foot of the Dream Machine. Dream takes the tag and takes over. Catches him with a clothesline. Dream covering Steve. Ooh. Kern, 1 1/4, and he was out of it. He gave him the count. Stan Lane jumps in. That's true, without a tag. Nails Porkchop Cash. Now we got all four of them in the ring as the referee tries to break up Chop. And out of the audience, coming in there, Hart's the Assassin. The big Assassin was sitting down in the audience. And they are slamming Steve Kern and Stan Lane around. Stan being worked over by the Assassins. And now while Porkchop holds Kern, Steve. They're going to win it, of course, by a disqualification, Dave. But the Assassins, can you believe, were sitting in the audience without their mask on, jumped into the ring. Big headbutt down on Stan, and Steve Kern taking a pounding.
The Bruise Brothers working on Steve, and they've got him cut, too.
Yeah. Here comes Dutch Mantel, the King, Coco Ware. The Assassins bail out of there. The Bruise
are your World Tag Team Champions, baby.
Didn't take but five of you in there, Jimmy. So the Bruise Brothers and the Assassins and Jimmy Hart feel like they've done a marvelous day's work when five of them jump on the Fabulous Ones. They busted Steve open. Stan was worked over very heavy by the Assassins right at the very beginning, and they continue to pound on him throughout the entire thing. What's the official on the match, Dave?
5 minutes, 58 seconds. Disqualification, so the Fabulous Ones will keep the World Tag Titles.
Little inspection of Steve Kern as he is whacked up pretty good as they nail him on the turnbuckle and every other way. The Fabs keep the titles. They did it in a hard way, too, by disqualification as the Assassins jumped in. Couldn't get over that. They came roaring out of the audience without their mask on. Our security people were heading to the ring. They were sitting apparently right in the front row. I haven't even paid any attention to anybody.
Well, one of them was sitting over across the way. He was sitting on the front row. He had an orange cap on, but as soon as he got to the ring, he threw that cap off, and they put the mask on, and it was obvious then that the Assassins.
They're going to be joined by Roughhouse Fargo in a match that will have the A-Team and the Russian Invader as their six-man match. Eddie, it was good to have you out here, sir.
Let me tell you something. You know, I've been coming out here and I've been taking Tattoo real light. I've been coming out here and making a joke about him all along, ever since he gone to the other side and chose his ways. Let me say, after this morning, Bill Dundee, I'm taking you a lot more serious. Take a real good look at my face. I know you're back there in the back laughing somewhere, thinking I got that big goof with me and I'm protected. All you got to do is you got to bring him down there with you and just stand him in the corner. Bill Dundee, your days as a wrestler are numbered in this area. You've been picking on everybody else all around, but you ain't picked on us. Now you've jumped into the fire, Dundee, and let me tell you what happens when you jump into the fire. You just take a good look at me, real close. If you can get that camera, I want you to zoom it right in on my face. Dundee, this is the worst sight you've ever seen, because every time you wake up in the morning, you're going to see me looking at you. When you look at your breakfast, you're going to want to puke because you're going to see me down in it, because I'm going to be right on your back. Dundee, your days as a wrestler are over. I laughed at you before, but I'm not laughing at you now. I'm going to laugh watching you leave this area, because when you're done with me, you ain't going to want to wrestle in this area ever again, because I'm going to humiliate you. You're half a man, Dundee, and you're going to be meeting a full man.
Eddie,
yeah, Lance, okay. I don't know where that other guy came from. He jumped out of the audience.
I don't know
if he thinks he's a wrestler or if he's just some reject from a Charles Manson clan or some Hell's Angels group. Let me tell you something, Dundee. I don't care if the guy's got tights or not. Bring his big carcass down there Monday night, too, because I'm going to get me some, too, Jack. I've fought big guys before. I've been wrestling for the past 6 or 7 months. I haven't used any karate because Eddie told me not to. But, son, Monday night, I'm going to get my foot up there. I don't care how tall he is, 6'4", 6'5", I'm going to kick your head, you big overgrown Bigfoot-looking goof. Let me say one thing, too. Monday night, we're not going to change our first match. We're bringing the Nut House with us. We're going to take care of that match. But, Eddie, we brought you out here for one reason. If you would sign one more match, the little midget Dundee, the half pint, and that big overgrown gorilla bring his, you know what, too, because we're going to get some of them too, Eddie, if you don't mind. Would you please?
What about it?
Lance, they want the match. I want the match. It is signed.
Right. Okay, well, that's fine. I'm not exactly sure who we got signed, but I know Dundee and whoever that guy that jumped in there, I think he was out there in the audience that just jumped in and helped. Well, I believe he's a friend of Dundee to have jumped in there helping Billy out in a situation when Steve Kern just about had him in there. So that match has been added to the card. Just put it along with all of the other great bouts that we listed in there. Also, that six-man, as Stan pointed out, will take place. That's Roughhouse joining the Fabulous Ones against the A-Team and all. But just add the Dundee and whoever it is that he will be in there with, the guy that helped him out today. That'll be added to Monday night. We're going to take time out. Be back with more action just...
Ladies and gentlemen, I feel like that I need to be here and make an explanation to you why you haven't seen the Fabulous Ones for about 6 weeks. Well, about a year ago, I took on two fine young athletes, dedicated, worked hard, sweat and blood, and give you everything they got. And they made it. Boy, they just did everything just great. I'll never take that away from them. But now, all of a sudden, they got where they didn't want to do what I told them. They didn't want to wrestle where I told them. They didn't want to wrestle in the South. They wanted to go to Chicago, Los Angeles, California, New York, And I said, pal, if you go, you're going without me. And you can drop the fab. It'll be Steve and Stan, not the Fabulous Ones anymore. There's one thing I told them when I first took them on. I said, listen, you walk into an arena, don't you ever walk by a little kid or a man or a woman without saying hi. And I want you to look up in that stand every time you go into an arena and say thank you for being here. Without you folks coming to the arena, we wouldn't be the Fabulous Ones. We wouldn't be wrestling here tonight. And don't you ever forget to say thank you. I wrestled around here all my life. I was born and raised in New York, but I wrestled right here in the good old South all my life, and I love it. And if they don't want to stay here to the kind of fans we got in this part of the country, then, ladies and gentlemen, all I can say is they can go on, but they'll be without me. And I promise you this, I'll find some more. And I'll be as proud of them, and I'll make you proud of them. I'll find you two fine, great Fabs. And I'm really looking forward to it. I've already got some in mind, but I won't go into the detail. But I felt like I needed to come out here and talk to you. And I hope now that you've understood what I've been trying to understand for the last 6 weeks. But I just told you the whole story, ladies and gentlemen. And remember this. I'll be back with two other Fabs that you'll love. Thank you very much for your time, and I'll see you around the towns. Don't worry, I'll still be in the good old South because I love it and I love you. I'll never forget you. And I'll never forget to say thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, after about 2,300 or 2,400 wrestlers talking to them and going to different cities and them coming to see me, search is finally over. I've found me two Fabulous Ones, two that I know that you're going to enjoy as much as anybody I could have ever found in the entire wrestling world. I got a fine tape here that I'd like for you to see. Then after the tape, I want to come back and I'll talk to these fine young fellas right after this tape. Hope you enjoy it. Certainly hope you enjoyed that, and sitting with me is the two new Fabulous Ones. On my left is Eddie Gilbert, and on my right, Tommy Rich. I think that you're really going to be proud, as I am, of these men. They know what to expect from me. They know what to expect from you. They've been in New York and Ohio and all over the North and all over the West. Now they're in the good old South. They both love hominy grits and hog jaws and black-eyed peas, baby. Tommy, Eddie, baby, we got our work cut out for us. I don't want 100% from you. I want 110. So let's get with it and be good boys and put out all you got. And don't ever forget the fans. They're the backbones of the whole thing. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you very much, and my new Fabs, baby, and we'll be seeing you around.
Thank you, Jackie.
I thought he was in New York City. Let me tell you something, baby. That didn't impress me. I've got the real Fabulous Ones right here. Jimmy Hart, hey, man, cut the stupid music up there. We're out here doing an interview. Hey, cut the tape, baby.
They are the new Fabulous Ones.
How you doing, bud? It's good to see you. It's good to be back home in the South.
And you know what? We know what Jackie expects of us, and we know what all these people expect, too. And we're here to deliver, baby.
All right, Tommy, welcome back. Eddie.
We know we got two big shoes to fill around here, but you look at two guys that can do it. We're going over here to see our people right now.
Very good. Eddie Gilbert, Tommy Rich, the new Fabulous One. Meet their fans right now. It's like Eddie said, they got some big shoes to fill. Think anybody do it? These two guys right there can. Bobby Rich, Eddie Gilbert, Jackie Fargo's you, Fabulous One. I'll tell you what, a big reach to fans. Let me just go ahead and take a break. We'll be back with more of Championship Wrestling. Belts right here, the Southern Tag Team titles. You won them in the tournament. I know you're not happy about what happened after that, though.
You know, Dave, before we start talking about what happened last week, I just, you know, Eddie and myself, we've been doing a lot of thinking. You know, when Jackie called, you know, and he asked us, you know, we had a chance to come back home and be a part of something that it's one of the biggest things in the country. You know, Jackie Fargo, you know, he's known all over the country. And it was a big thing, you know, to come back and especially to get to be one of Jackie Fargo's Fabulous Ones. You know, but just like I said last week, I don't know, we won the match, we won the belts, and but when we was laying there, Norvell and Coco or whatever they want to be called, I don't, you know, that right now I'm talking about something that really it's bothered Eddie and it's bothered me.